This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. So next, the critical piece that we'll be talking about, and we've seen some of this earlier with some of our stateful set deployments and other things, is how do you store data so that it persists longer than the lifetime of the pod itself? If you do not define some sort of persistent storage for your pods, then you, when that pod goes away, any data that was stored inside that pod also goes with it. But if you attach a volume inside that pod, now that can be saved separate from the lifecycle of that pod. So a persistent volume is a piece of storage in the cluster that has been provisioned by an administrator or dynamically provisioned using a storage class. Dynamic provisioning is great because essentially you can define a big pool of storage. And then once there's a persistent volume claim, you don't have to go and ask your administrator to create a persistent volume, but rather it will just grab from that pool of storage. PVs are resources in the cluster just like a node, so essentially they are long-lived. PVs are volume plugins like volumes, but have a lifecycle independent of any individual pod that uses the PV. And for MinIO, the persistent volume is the storage that is used for the MinIO server, also sometimes referred to and kind of associated with a pool in MinIO terminology. There's also an associated piece where if you're not defining the persistent volume, you're defining a persistent volume claim. So you're claiming that space for a workload. Again, you will want to use a backend storage subsystem that supports automatically provisioning the persistent volume when you have a claim so that you're not manually doing both. A persistent volume claim is a request for storage by a user or whatever you're deploying, the service that you're deploying. And similar to a pod where pods consume node resources, persistent volume claims consume persistent volume resources or storage resources. For MinIO, the persistent volume claim is a request for storage that is used by the MinIO server. So let's go take a look at the persistent volumes and persistent volume claims in our demo. So here we are in our demo environment, and let's take a look at our YAML files for our persistent volume and persistent volume claims. So here's our persistent volume definition, and you can see here that this definition is essentially saying that I want to create a persistent volume and I want the size to be 1 gigabyte and I want it attached to the local path storage class. Then we're also defining access mode as read write once. Now this can be read only for some use cases or read write many for other use cases. But in this case, most of the time, what you're going to see is read write once. We can also take a look at the persistent volume claim. And the persistent volume claim is essentially saying, I want to grab some storage from this local path provisioner, and the access mode is read write once, and I want 1 gig. Now, I'm showing you the persistent volume here because, again, some storage subsystems do not automatically provision storage when there is a claim. Now, in this case, the one that we are running does, so we do not need to define the persistent volume. We can just define a claim, and it will automatically provision that storage for us. So let's go ahead and take a look at our persistent volumes first. And you can see that there are two persistent volumes that are associated with our stateful set, that web one and web zero that I was showing off earlier. So let's go ahead and create a new persistent volume claim that will automatically create a persistent volume for that storage. Actually, first, let's take a look at the persistent volume claims that exist in the MinIO namespace first. So you can see here, there are two claims that are associated with those two persistent volumes. So a claim asks for storage. The volume is what actually gets provisioned and passed back to the claim. And then that gets handed off to a pod for its storage, long-term storage outside of the lifecycle of that pod. So now let's apply our persistent volume claim. So the claim was created, and if we go back and we check our PVCs, I did not define that that should be inside the MinIO namespace, so that will just be in our main usage here. Now, the reason that it's pending is because it's waiting for a consumer, so it's not attached to anything. So because we haven't defined a pod that's going to use this particular claim, it's not going to automatically take that storage up. But typically, you would deploy this alongside some workload that needs this. So that status would automatically be bound. But in this case, it's not because there is nothing associated with it. So that's sort of some of the high level inner workings of how persistent volumes and claims work within Kubernetes. But again, this is for the persistent storage and longer lifecycle storage than pods have inside your cluster. So you'll really want to use this because otherwise you'll be losing data every time a pod gets reallocated or has to be restarted. Thanks for joining us for this Kubernetes overview topic as part of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.